Welcome to another episode of the Planetary Persuader. I am Kozmic Kev, your host, and this is for the week beginning with Friday, the 15th of July, going all the way over till the 21st, to Thursday, to the 22nd next week. So this is, you know, for you Cancerians in Western astrology, this is your last big week, all right? Okay, but we got something else going on here. We have a big, fat, full moon at 2740 degrees Capricorn in Western astrology, which basically means 3 degrees Capricorn in Vedic astrology. Now, the Jupiter aspect of Sagittarius teaches wisdom, but, you know, Saturn teaches about the necessities, and sleep is a necessity. And that's why there's like planks, like a bed. And it's also ruled by the sun. And the sun is always showing light. You know, it's always beaming on us a certain amount of wisdom. And this new wisdom can help us in avoiding harsh realities. It's like it shows a life lived in public with an inner desire to be alone. And since it's like more of a moksha part of the moon cycle, which is, you know, the winter signs, basically, including Sagittarius through Pisces. And we're looking for more spiritual enlightenment. And so this is from the necessary, the rulership of the sun makes a little more sattvic. There's some, even though it's Saturn, it's like, well, we have to pay attention to rules and to what our limits are. It's all there, you know. And so I would be paying attention to this full moon. And, you know, I would, you know, maybe say a little prayer to Ganesh, remover of obstacles, or, you know, just to God, meditations, whatever you need to do to make this work. I mean, one of the things I'm going to need to make this work is get myself a glass of water, which never quite happened today. Sorry. it's not there. But anyhow, we're going to just go sign by sign as to what happened. So that's the 19th. I think it's like around 4 o'clock in the afternoon, Pacific time, 3:56 to be exact. Thank you, sir. And, yeah, we've had some warm weather here. It's not so bad right now for the moment. But we're going to go sign by sign. You know, here we are. And your sign of the zodiac. So, Aries, it's up to you. So Uranus has really progressed pretty far. I think it's like at 23, 24 degrees now. It's pretty, you know, it's getting closer and closer to Taurus every single day. So, I think we're still at the 24 degree mark. But it's going direct, and it is going to go retrograde later on this year. So I'd say there's this full-fledged excitement. There's this need to express yourself as an individual, and you're attracted to more kinds of radical politics or new technology obsessions. Anything that's exciting. You know, Uranus is sort of like the planet of excitement. But Cancer time is about how you find your bliss, your happiness, your tribe, your relationship to your mother. Not for everyone is that good. You know, so I have a lot of compassion. Most of us didn't get the parents we wanted, I know. But some do very well in spite of that. And some never get it together and live the life of a miscreant. So, I mean, as far as your Mars situation, it's in Scorpio still. And, but I think it's out of that, it's getting out of that really dangerous zone that it was in before, where in sidereal astrology, it actually visited the constellation of Libra, forbidden territory for Mars. No. And It is, yeah. Now it is pretty much, as of this weekend, you're in the clear, you know, even today. You're in the clear. It's back in Scorpio, and so it's in the eighth house, and so there's a lot of things that happen to us that we can't necessarily control, but if we explore our curiosity to do good in the world and help and pray for others, even if there's no blessing, this is a time for karma yoga. It's a time to do things that help other people and not just yourself, and it will alleviate any bad karma. We also start this weekend with Saturn and the Moon together, which is like a little mini Saturn Sate, you know, and there's just a lot of harsh things with the North Node and Jupiter having been as close as they've been. We're experiencing some hardship and things that are really trying us physically. Hang in there. The weekend, at least, you know, today sounds great. You know, it's going to be a good day for you, so we can leave it at that. All right, well, greetings, Taurus. Welcome to your horoscope. So, we're working on bringing more peace and stability. We don't always know how to do that. We don't always know where we have the best reasoning, but what's nice about now is that this is a good time to improve your communication. This is a good time to reach out to old friends, to reach out to siblings, and to have courage and to explore things and to let your curiosity take you places you've never seen it go before. Now, Venus is now in your fourth house. So Venus is in this place where you're seeking more personal happiness. You know, your creature comforts, fixing up your home, honoring your mother in some way. And, yeah, it's okay. It's a good thing to do. And you're hungry for more fulfillment in your creative life. And that is a good thing. And relationship strife and differences, you know, it has to be addressed sometimes. It has to be looked at. And we've also got Saturn in the eighth house, you know, with the Moon. And so that's kind of a tougher aspect. It's a little bit depressing. You might be feeling like this is kind of a drag weekend. And I got to do some things to get myself out of the blues. It could also be, you know, a masterful where you have realizations about your own creative process, your own sexuality, your own attitudes towards death, and, you know, a lot of. Hello, Gemini, and welcome to your horoscope. So Mercury is now in Leo, which is actually your third house. So now you really got to be a chatterbox and got a lot to talk about. Gemini here, Gemini there. Gemini. You know how it is, that whole interplay of information that goes from the twins. Now, one thing I learned recently in Vedic astrology, the Gemini was actually a divine couple. And I look at least in the Western astrology sense of planetary cycles, really, that they kind of last like 7 years. Like, first 7 years of your life, you're baby, you're Aries, you know. From 7 to 14, you go from, you know, middle-aged kid to, you know, budding adolescent. And so you become a things person, like, oh, I want my identifications down, you know, what my ownership is of what, you know. But 14 to 21 is generally when you really fall in love for the first time. And I often say, you know, Gemini's in perpetual search of a soulmate now. Now, you've got the Sun's in the second house, so you're dealing with money details, money worries, but it's mostly about communication, finding that loved one that makes you feel good, your friend from the past. And it's also like when Mars transiting your sixth house, it's about getting in shape, cleaning up your house, getting more physically shaped, adding your own strength to help others, you know. And I say, if you do good work helping others in the sixth house, if sixth house is in drishti with the 12th house, it makes your karma better. You know, it shines on that 12th house too, and it makes it better. So when you go through those isolating hardships, they're not quite as bad because you did the work in the community in the 6th house when they needed you. So, yeah, let's do that thing. And the moon this weekend, at least, is very romantic. Now, the full moon can lead you to higher knowledge and really good fortune, and you know, it also, the beginning of it might be dealing more with other people's property, and later on when it goes into your ninth house, then it's, you know, seeking wisdom and going to holy places like Mount Shasta or Bald Rock, or you know, maybe there's another local spot where you live that is a sacred spot, and that's a good thing. Sacred pilgrimages are good. Well, greetings, Cancer. Welcome to your horoscope. This is your last week of full-on Cancerian glory in the Western astrology sense of things. So, you know, your key phrase is, I feel. And as we go later into signs, we get a more advanced information from what we were doing. And there's more spiritual implications that go with that as well. So, this weekend, moon in Sagittarius, it's like sixth house, do your work, Friday, Saturday, get stuff done. Do your karma yoga, you know, and then it gets kind of romantic. It's sort of romantic by the time we get to Sunday afternoon, all the way through a good portion of Tuesday, where the moon's in your seventh house and this waxing moon getting full. So a love relationship can really build during this cycle. Now, one of the things, though, is it gets deeper, because, you know, a full moon, right after the full moon, Tuesday night, it crosses into that eighth house zone, you know, which rules sexuality, death of the ego, and inheritance, things you can't control, gifts that come out of nowhere, and things that get ripped off out of nowhere, loss, and you just got to just let go of the control trip, and you'll be fine, you know, you're going to face it with flying colors. Well, hello, Leo. And welcome to your horoscope. So, what do I need to say to you? Well, we got Venus and Mercury in the first house. This is actually helping a lot right now. It's making you a little more relaxed because you've been in a really confused and darker place as the sun's been transiting your 12th house. So it's like you're not necessarily happy with everything that's going on. And it's easy to have your blind spot, to be a part of your own undoing. Oh, those 12th house periods, I always like, I just feel like sometimes they say the 8th house is the most dangerous, actually, of all the malefic houses, 6th, 8th, 12th, 6th is the worst, but 12th can be pretty bad because you can be really unconscious. And so it's like, pay attention to your dreams, pay attention to your blind spots, pay attention to your people that you're not good with, and try to befriend them. Now, this is also a good time to deal with money issues, although they're harsh because of Jupiter being somewhat afflicted by Rahu. I mean, it's helping the Rahu, the North Node, but I don't know if it necessarily helps the Jupiter. We have a hunger, and you know, we seem to be going through money. So we need to make some changes. And we need to affirm what they have. One interesting little Vatsu thing I learned over the weekend at Shivananda was that it's a really good idea to put money in every room of your house, have a little money, like change or something, because it's like the money circulates better that way. And if you got like $1,000 to give away, it would be better to take a dollar every day and give it to 1,000 different people, 1,000 different places, so that the love is spread. These are little ideas on how to make good money karma. I just wanted to bring it up to you, share it with you. You know, sometimes the fourth house is vehicles. You may have to work on your car. I usually see a lot of problems when the Mars goes through the third, but it's back in the fourth. And, you know, and just taking action on your happiness, taking action on your home, taking action on real estate, taking action on your domestic situation, your tribe, your people, showing yourself to be a leader. You know, at least within your own mind and in your own wisdom. So looking at that, adopting some kind of leadership ability, it's a good thing. Pluto in the sixth house, you know, working on long-term health issues. Then there's also Neptune in the eighth, Uranus in the ninth. I mean, Uranus is probably going to help. If you take a vacation, it's going to be good. You know, 12th house period's a great time for a vacation. I'll tell you, it's a really good time to have a getaway. It helps. And if you want to go to exotic foreign lands, it's good for that too. Well, hello, Virgo. And welcome, welcome, welcome to your horoscope. Okay. So what's the deal here? Well, Cancer is really a friendly house. It actually rules benefic relationships. Friends that have the same interests as you. That's what the 11th house is about. These are the people you party with. So it's kind of your last week to get together with them and really party it up and just kind of feel good and appreciate them. Now, you got Venus and Mercury in your 12th house. Now, with Mercury in the 12th, I say pay attention to your dreams. Maybe keep a dream journal. Pay attention to symbols. What they mean. And not everything's two ways. Not everything's just black and white. They're both. And so you're going to have to decipher a lot of gray matter. You just have to be careful about people at work. So there is still, you know, some kind of feeling that you're not sure where you stand in your relationship. But I think when I see Neptune in the seventh house, it's like partner up with the angelic versus the demonic, you know. In other words, get right with God. Get right with the Malkania. Get right with the spiritual in your life. Whatever that means to you. And sometimes the best we can do is just like sit by a stream and talk to the birds. You know, there's nothing wrong with that. It could help. It could be easing on your mind. But meditate. You know, you might have some transportation issues because of Mars transiting the third. You have a lot more courage than usual to get things done. I would just say, you know, sometimes you just have to rest and be blessed. But don't take anything for granted. I mean, really, right now. I mean, you have Jupiter and Rahu, North Node, in the first house. So you're really hungry. You have a strong desire for stuff. You don't really, that you're going to learn a lot, you know. You're really able to take in more information than ever and synthesize it. And that is a beautiful thing, you know. Your voracious intellect, but you're still working on your home environment and amongst your tribe and where you feel happy, but also where you feel depressed. You know, there's dual issues going on this weekend. And I just think, you know, allow other people's acts to inspire you and move forward. Well, hello, Libra. And welcome, welcome, welcome to your horoscope. So today we have the sun in your 10th house of career looking good. You're looking brilliant. You're looking like a leader. You're looking like someone people want to relate to, that they want to go with and do things with. So this is a wonderful time for that for you. Now, you've got Mars in the second house. So Mars in the second house, there's a need to let your voice be known. Sometimes there's things that need work on, like you might have hurt your neck, or I need some dental work. That there's things like that. I think of like selling tools to get a job, or buying the right tools for the right job. Starting with the moon this weekend. You know, it's all about your environment, where you live, enjoying your own hobbies and talents, feeling good. You know, even if you feel bad, you still feel a little bit good. And working in your home life, you got to make a transformation. And this full moon coming up, It's going to be about having fun and about creative expression and what goes on with your children and how you want to be in love. But there's a bit of a party with Venus and Mercury. Venus and Mercury are partying in your 11th house, and Jupiter and Rahu are doing their thing in the 12th house, so it's like you're hungry to make your spiritual life right. You like being nice and doing the right thing. I totally get this. But, you know, get enough sleep, take care of your health, and move on. Well, hail Scorpio, and how are you doing on this day? I mean, yesterday the moon was in your sign. Today it is in Sagittarius, second house. So you're kind of like focused more on your money issues right now. Am I right? Yeah. No, we got them for sure. And so we have to put some remedies, you know, out there for it. And one thing is, one great remedy is to start with, well, I am thankful that I have this, and this, you know. And I mean, if you're a homeless person, you know, you're like, I'm thankful for my dog, or, you know, I'm thankful for my shelter, and or my freedom. I'm thankful for my freedom. You know, there's that too. You have good friends around you, but you have some people that want to exploit that energy. Because Rahu is a snake, you know, it's like the north end of the, it's a cobra bite. But it's got no arms. It tends to use other people. Now, your intelligence and your creative ability are being seen at work right now, and this is a beautiful thing. Also, the sun in your ninth house is actually a very lucky period for you. So I see good fortune coming your way. And I know. You're like, hey, man, it's about time. I need it. And I'm like, yeah, I agree. Now, Scorpio, you've been through the ringer, you know, last couple years. So, or more. And so, you know, there's some nectar. There's some goodness coming to you from your friends, from your people. And you got energy, too, because you got that Mars, you know, back. And Mars is, you know, is doing its thing. But learn how to be sustainable. Full moon is about learning how to be happy again. Pay attention to your spiritual life. There's a lot of happiness there as well. Okay. Greetings, Sagittarius. Welcome to your horoscope. But Cancer time is not an easy time for Sagittarius. It rules the 8th house. 8th house is other people's property, sex, death, mystical studies, inheritance. You know, an inheritance, although you might get a gift, it's usually not that happy. You know, I'm an experienced middle-aged guy, and my parents are still alive. I'm going to be dreadful about losing them. You know, because they pray for me, they care for me, they care for each other. There's so many things going on that are so beautiful about this couple who is now in their 80s. And I just wish blessings upon them, and that's what we all should be doing. So, I mean, you get inspiration from taking risks right now, from being with wild people. You like that. It's fun. But you need to make your home a spiritual sanctuary for yourself. And this is a really great time for vacation, for meeting people, especially going to sacred sites, places far away, places where you can meet enlightened people. It's a good time for that. In spite of not having so much control over things, you also still, your talents and skills are shining through. You just got to watch your back a little bit, because not everybody's feeling you, you know, and that's that Mars in the 12th house. So being an active prayer warrior, that would be a good way to go at this time. That's what I'm thinking. Well, hello, Capricorn, and welcome to your horoscope. So, you know, this is your partnership sign, Cancer. That's where the sun is. Yes, you can fall in love. It's safe. It get really juicy because Venus and Mercury are in your 8th house, so you got sex on the brain, and your body wants it too. But you might just have to do your spiritual work and show up in the ashram anyhow. We've got Jupiter and the North Node in the ninth house, so in a sense, there's some good fortune coming to you. Even though things are rough right now, see, there is what I would call a certain sense of rather good fortune coming to you. So, yeah, I know. So, with that in mind, I lost my grip. I used to have a stage grip at one time here, you know, but they're hard to find, and you know, good help's hard to find. So, I am looking at you being able to write about your dreams, write about your spiritual journey. And you got some strong people in your life, but you have to pay attention to Saturn too, because, you know, not having real defined limits, not keeping up with deadlines and promises to people, Saturn hates that stuff. So if you've lied and been fake just to protect your butt, oh my God, are you kidding me? The more you delay the pain, the more you delay the prosecution for what you've done, the worse it's going to come down on you. And that's the sad part. But we could change all this right away if you just come clean. Get well. Get the help you need. Come clean. And then, you know, be in a happy place. You will be able to reap that good luck and everything. The full moon is in your sign at 27 degrees Capricorn, okay? It's in your sign in both Vedic and Western astrology. Capricorn moon's a heavy-duty moon, folks. You know, it's not always... But this is also considered the moon of the guru in Hindu astrology. This is time of year coming on. So this is guru's grace. So we do need some of that. It is a sun-ruled nakshatra. So guru's grace coming to us, you know. And so we do get some of that Vrishapati Jupiter energy, too. All right. So, greetings, Aquarius. Welcome your horoscope. You know, it's like Cancer deals with six house issues, which is your health, long-distance relatives from out of town, working with others, giving service. You know, that's really where a lot of the focus is. I mean, Saturn's still in the good house of the 11th house, along with the moon this weekend. You're going to make this fun. You're going to work with the energies. You're that kind of person. And the full moon... That night, it does go into Aquarius, so, I mean, you're gonna be the spotlight of attention the 19th, the 20th, even the 21st, so. Enjoy yourself towards midweek. That's how I'll look at it. Alright, so, greetings Pisces, this is the wrap-up, this is where we take you back. You know, Cancer time's a water sign just like you, so it rules the fifth house, and so this makes you more creative. This gives you creative inspiration right now. But some of that creative inspiration is going to have to be brought on the table to help others, to be given to friends, to be a giveaway, to make good karma, because part of the sixth house is charitable causes, it's serving others. And you get a little bit for it, you know, you get a little food, a shelter, you should have that, you know, everyone deserves that. But it's not where you're going to get rich quick. Partnership issues, there is some grace there. You know, there's a healing there. There's something wonderful happening in your partnership. I see that in my Pisces friends. Mars in the ninth. Now's the time to take the risk, to climb the big mountain, you know, and to do Mount Shasta. Get yourself in shape, you know, to run the half marathon next year. Whatever it is your goal is, get yourself going. You look good at work. You know, you don't have to trick yourself. Yeah, enjoy this weekend. And the full moon will be in your party house. It's going to be fun. Thanks for being with me this week. We're going to do this again next week on the Planetary Persuader. Yay!
Yay! It's another Kozmic Kev Planetary Experience.
Yay!